Yes, the theme from the Munsters can only mean one thing. I'm now going to turn to my very special guest, the legend that is, the icon of paranormal investigations, the man who put the C back into chat, Chad Warnford, about paranormal investigations. And my first question to you on this subject, can you wake up, Chad?
What?
Can you wake up?
Oh, all right, okay.
You're
sorry,
on the radio now.
Are we starting?
Yes.
All right, okay.
Wake up.
Bah, right.
Is paranormal investigations, what's that all about?
Well, Paul, what it's all about, it's basically things like crop circles, because, back in 1972, I saw that my first crop circle, it was amazing.
Sorry to interrupt you there, Chad. Hang on, just sorry to interrupt you. It's a bit stuffy, it's a bit hot in here.
Oh, no.
So what I'm going to do is just open the window. All right, just going to open the window.
Right.
Might be a minute, just going to open the window. Okay, here we go, just open the window. Just get a bit of fresh air in here, all right, Chad?
Oh, you start it.
Lovely birds. Oh, beautiful. It's a nice river out there, splashing through. It's beautiful, isn't it? You feel a bit more fresh now, don't you?
Yeah, it's Stroud, isn't it? It's nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it's lovely.
I love Stroud.
That's fantastic. Oh, that's better. Now we can carry on feeling invigorated and refreshed.
Yeah, right.
See, lovely birds out there, isn't it? Nice and calm and What a surprise, Chad. Not only have we got beautiful birds, but we've got the Stroud Guild of Retired Bricklayers Quartet playing some beautiful classical music to soothe our nerves. Yeah, paranormal investigations, Chaddy darling. What's that all about?
Chaddy darling? Right, anyway, where was I? Oh, you was talking about trucks. Yeah, no, I wasn't.
We've been asking that question for a long time, where you are.
Anyway, I was talking about crop circles when I saw one back in 1972. It's really good. Yeah, and I've been seeing loads of them since. And I'll be talking about that later. Anyway, one of the other things I'm going to do is UFOs. Because I saw a UFO.
Where
in Stroud, believe it or not, and I tell you about that.
Can't I get a decent
really
guest
good story
for once? Just
it
for
is.
Once.
And then,
Somebody, monsters.
I'm going to be talking about monsters because I see loads and loads of monsters all over the place. I saw one in London once. Yeah, it was amazing. I'd never seen anything like it. It was this monster, right? And it was in the Thames. And it looked,
just for once, it'd be nice to get a good guess.
It was in the Thames. I was by the Houses of the Parliament. I was. And this bloke came up and he threw something at it. Well, the monster swallowed it. And then it disappeared. But there were nothing in the papers. There were nothing in the papers at all. Hang on, who's that? What's going on?
Well, it's down at the end of Lone Street, that Heartbreak Hotel.
Sorry to interrupt you there, Chad, but none other than Elvis Presley, who's a big fan of yours and a member on your Facebook page, has come into the studio today to share with you his thoughts and feelings about paranormal investigations. Welcome to the show, King. Oh, welcome, man. Lovely to be here. Yeah, it's great to have you here. I love your show, man. Thanks, Elvis. It's great, yeah. Elvis likes my show, Chad.
Elvis.
I love you too, man. Oh, thanks, Elvis. What about Chad? Do you like him? No, man, I don't know. No, I've got no time for him, man. No. Okay. Chad, sorry about that.
Seemed better than you, mate.
King. Sorry, King. We're going to have to get back to you in a minute because I've got to talk to Chad. I'll be talking to you in a minute, King. I used to love you, man. Okay, Chad, yeah, carry on. What's paranormal activities?
Well, come in.
Lordy, Miss Claudia.
Actually, I was just talking about, I was going to move on, about ghosts, and we just had one here.
King must sleep.
See, because I believe about ghosts. Well, I was told
by a bloke. Hang on. Where are you going, King? Where are you going? I'm going to go and get a bacon sandwich, man. Can you get me one? Do you want a bacon sandwich, Chad?
He's dead.
Do you want a bacon sandwich?
No, I'm all right, thanks.
Do you?
I'll tell you,
I have an egg sandwich, King. All right. Want an egg sandwich, man? Yeah, I'll have an egg sandwich. Want sauce on that, man? Yeah, I'll have sauce on that, yeah. I'll be back in about 5, man. Lordy, Miss Claudia. Thanks, Elvis. See you a bit later. I love your show, man. Thanks, Elvis. Yeah, carry on, Chad.
Anyway, he had to be a ghost, and that's one of the things I'm into, because a bloke told me, you see, down a pub a few years ago, he said.
I love that quintet.
Fabulous story he was telling me about. He said there's a big magnet underneath the earth, here. And what it does, you know those old tapes here, those videotapes here? Well, apparently they're full of magnets, and that's how we could play them back. Now, I reckon, right, that this big magnet, when something really interesting happens on earth, you know, like sort of, I can't think, really. But anyway, if anything really funny happens, any interesting things, anything like battles and stuff like that.
Sorry, King.
What's the matter?
Can you keep your voice down? I'm trying to listen to this lovely music. Got beautiful music here. You're talking over it. We got the lovely birds. Can we just appreciate this peace and quiet for a minute? Listen,
got birds.
It's lovely out there. Just listen. Listen. It's lovely.
All right.
Well, maybe not. Yeah, carry on, Chad.
Well, that's my sort of farmer. Right then. Anyway, and another thing, there, and I reckon that what happens with these ghosts is that when something happens, it's like on a video tape and on an audio tape, not like the stuff they got down there, rubbish, no far fowl stuff, right, that it plays it back. And I reckon that's where a ghost is, and I reckon that the Earth years ago, it used to be in a different place, and that's why you see him floating in the air. And then the other thing...
Sorry to interrupt you, Chad. But none other than Elton John has come into the studio singing Blue Eyes. And it's any old excuse to play live. He knows I've got blue eyes, and he's come in to sing it. What are you looking at me like that for? He's come in to sing Blue Eyes. It's any old cheap trick to get a few more minutes on the radio. Elton, no, no, no. You can be a guest on my show some other time. Well, I've got a long waiting list. About 6 months. I'll fit you in about 6 months, all right? Right, can you stop? Reg! Reg! Not now! Not now! Security, can we take him out? Can we take Reg out? Thank you. Reg, can you go? Thanks. All right, Chad.
Yeah,
sorry about that. Sorry,
it's my old... uncle, that bloke, yet.
Who, Elton?
No, Reg.
Reg?
Yeah, Reg. Right.
Yeah, that is Elton John.
Is that?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
So, Chad... What are your thoughts about crop circles?
Oh, well, I reckon that it's UFOs.
Is anyone listening to this?
I reckon it's aliens.
Really, is anyone listening to this?
It's definitely, because I've seen them.
Because I'm not.
I saw them. I was up one night and I saw these aliens coming down and they had these sticks on their feet. Yeah, they did. They had these sticks on their feet and they were walking around with this. I couldn't believe it. Yeah, funny people they were. And then they had this big long
rope. So, Chad, you think that crop circles are caused by UFOs, do you?
Aliens are.
Yeah?
Aliens.
That's what you think, is it?
Well, you know, I saw that. I watched that.
Have you?
I saw it. Well,
it's on your Facebook page as well, your thing.
I knows that. Yeah.
I'm sorry, I will take you seriously.
The last time I came on here, honestly.
Chad.
Not fair.
Chad, I am taking you seriously. Oh. Seriously, I am. I am. Oh, great, I got that note. I've been trying for weeks to get that.
You really did play that too. That was quite good.
Huh? Brilliant.
I was impressed.
Fantastic. Yeah, you carry on.
Next one, Phil.
That's all right. Right, yeah, Paul, yeah. Right, Paul, okay. Just remember, my name is Paul.
I've been saying it to myself ever since I came on the show. Remember that. What do you want to know?
Listen, I can't get my head down on this, Chad. UFO, you honestly expect me to believe that UFOs come from...
Well, I told you!
I don't believe it.
I told you!
I don't believe
it.
There we are! We've actually got a UFO has just come down from the sky and is landing outside on the lawn next to the studio.
Like
I would never have believed this in a million years. You talking about UFOs, Chad, and here we have a UFO landing in the studio.
I thought we're just like that.
Listen. It's landed. There's a bright light shining through the door. Chad, something's coming through the door. Something's coming through the door, Chad. Chad, someone's coming in.
What was that?
Oh, it's E.T. It's E.T. E.T.'s just walked through the door. All right, E.T. What do you want, E.T.? Stop laughing. No, that's not happening. No, you're not borrowing my mobile phone to call home. Do you know how big that bill would be? Go on, get out. Chad, can you open the door and let him out?
We can.
Let him out. There he goes. Wants to borrow my mobile phone to call home.
You're a little bigger already.
God, do you know how much that would cost? There he goes. Go on, find somebody else to use a phone. What is he like? What is he like?
What a job and all. Right, what's going on?
So, Chad, I know that you investigate UFO sightings, and we've just seen one. I was going to ask you, do they exist? That question has just gone out the window, hasn't it?
Yeah.
But I understand that you ever had a sighting of the Loch Ness Monster.
Yeah.
Can you tell us something about that?
I just told you about it. Where are you listening?
I was miles away, sorry.
I was telling you about the one when I was in London, by the Houses of Parliament.
I was doing my shopping list.